The nation's longest reigning monarch passed away aged 96 at her private royal residence in the Scottish Highlands, one of her favourite places, as close family rushed to be at her side. Charles has become King Charles III, having acceded to the throne immediately on the death of his mother, and Camilla is now Queen Consort. In a statement at 6:30 p.m., the palace said, "The Queen died peacefully at Balmoral this afternoon. The King and the Queen Consort will remain at Balmoral this evening and will return to London tomorrow." The UK will enter a period of national mourning for the Queen, who dedicated her life to royal duty and for most Britons is the only monarch they have ever known. In a statement, Charles said, "The death of my beloved mother, Her Majesty the Queen, is a moment of the greatest sadness for me and all members of my family. We mourn profoundly the passing of a cherished sovereign and a much-loved mother. I know her loss will be deeply felt throughout the country, the realms and the Commonwealth, and by countless people around the world. During this period of mourning and change, my family and I will be comforted and sustained by our knowledge of the respect and deep affection in which the Queen was so widely held. The Queen's coffin will lie in State Westminster Hall in the Palace of Westminster to allow the public to pay their last respects, before her funeral is held in Westminster Abbey in around 10 days. Liz Truss, who was appointed as Prime Minister by the Queen on Tuesday, said her death was a huge shock to the nation and the world. She concluded her address outside No. 10 this evening by saying, "God save the King." Crowds began gathering outside Buckingham Palace in central London this afternoon. People sang the national anthem, with some weeping when officials carried a notice confirming the Queen's death to the gates and the flag was lowered to half-mast. Floral tributes have also been laid outside Windsor Castle and Balmoral. Former Prime Minister Mr. Johnson said Britain is enduring its saddest day following the death of Elizabeth the Great. He was among the 6 living ex-premiers to pay tribute. The Archbishop of Canterbury said his prayers are with the King and the royal family as he mourns the death of the Queen, whose steadfast loyalty, service and humility has helped us make sense of who we are. Labour leader Sir Keir Starmer said, "Above the clashes of politics, she stood not for what the nation fought over, but what it agreed upon. As Britain changed rapidly around her, this dedication became the still point of our turning world. So as our great Elizabethan era comes to an end, we will honour the late Queen's memory by keeping alive the values of public service she embodied." US President Joe Biden and First Lady Jill Biden said the Queen was more than a monarch and that she defined an era, while French leader Emmanuel Macron said she was a friend of France. Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky tweeted, "It is with deep sadness that we learned of the death of Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II. On behalf of the people, we extend sincere condolences to the royal family, the entire United Kingdom and the Commonwealth over this irreparable loss. Our thoughts and prayers are with you." The royal family's website is currently displaying a black background with an image of the Queen on her coronation day in 1953. The page also shows a white royal crest and the Queen's year of birth and year of death 1926 to 2022.
Thank you. the worst that feels to the worst.